Greetings to our viewers at home. My name is Thandeka Mkhize from AfriSog, and today I have a special guest. Sawubona baba.
Yebo sisunjani.
I'm good, and how are you?
I'm doing well.
I'm good. Could you please introduce yourself and where you're coming from?
Yeah, my name is Tito Haguma from Durban, and I work for Upskill Africa Initiative, Menelda and Trinity Church in West Africa.
Oh, and what is your relationship with AfriSog?
We've been working together with AfriSog for so many years in the same field of social cohesion, promoting harmony in our communities.
Yeah. Oh, all right. Wow, social cohesion, such a big word. From someone who's hearing it from the first time, how could you explain the word social cohesion, and what are the pillars of social cohesion in the community?
Yeah, the word social cohesion is something new in our communities, but the way I can define it is like a strength of relationship between people from different backgrounds and the level of understanding and trusting each other in that harmony or living together in harmony.
All right. Mm-hmm. Okay. And from time to time, people speak of foreign nationals, not knowing that there are also categories from there. Could you explain more, like differentiate between a refugee, an asylum seeker, a migrant, and a stateless person?
That's a very good question. And I always tell people that we are all foreigner in different ways, you know. Because if you, like, I ask you, maybe you were born here in Richards Bay.
Yeah.
What about your parent? You will find out that they were born somewhere in Ishowe.
Yeah.
What about your grandparent?
Grandparents.
From somewhere else.
Yeah.
So there are many reasons people come to different communities and places. That's why there are different categories of people. Yeah, we start with citizens. When you talk about citizens, it's all about people who were born there, parents born there, you know.
Yeah.
They have all the covering of their government in the country. They enjoy the goodness of the country.
Mm-hmm.
And we talked about economic migrant. These are the people who move from
one
point A to point B for one reason, to make money.
Money, okay.
Yeah, because they see that the grass are green that side, and then they move there, they make money, and they go back to their places.
Yes.
You know, somebody can come from Johannesburg to Durban as an economic migrant, you know, to come there. Somebody can come from Malawi, Zambia. Like in South Africa, most of economic migrants are from our neighboring countries.
Yes.
Yeah. And also we have
refugees.
These are the people who run away from their countries because of fear of persecution.
Oh, yes.
Maybe there's war, whatever. So they become refugees to another country.
Yeah.
Meaning they cross the border seeking a peaceful shelter, asylum.
Asylum.
You know?
Mm.
So they become refugees when their cases are approved by the new place, the new government, the new countries. While they are still applying to be recognized as a refugees, we call them asylum seekers.
Oh.
So asylum seekers are also people who run away from their country.
Yeah, still in the process.
Years. Yeah, to become refugees.
Oh, and what about the stateless person?
And then we have stateless people. Stateless people, these are people who don't have any document, like ID. They are not recognized by any state.
Mm.
So some of them, you find out that they were born, they are South Africans, but their parents did not take them to Home Affairs for birth certificate. So now they have no ID. They can't even apply for IDs. Others are from outside. You know, when you talk about human trafficking, they've been trafficked when they were small. They dumped them to other countries. They don't know where they come from.
Oh, yeah.
So they are stateless. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. And in conclusion, what message would you tell our listeners at home in an area of social cohesion? Just a message to our listeners.
So the message to our listeners now is that we are living, the world has become like a global village where a Chinese can earn his or her living in South Africa.
Yes.
Where an African can learn, earn his living in America.
Yeah.
You know, so the world has become a global village. So we are no more focusing like locally in local.
Oh, yeah.
So please get your passport and move. try whatever.
Yeah.
You know? And
yeah.
we can't stop that because that's where we are. With technologies, we are connected. So let's welcome people from different countries.
Yes.
Let's know each other and work together for development.
All right. Thank you so much. As you've heard, Pastor Tito, let us all welcome one another. Let us all live in peace. And thank you. Please tune in for more interviews, more podcasts. And please do not forget to like and subscribe our page. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you.